Hello everyone, Samantha here. I pray all is well with you. This is my final video in my quick, simple Bible journaling series. I think this is the 10th video. Yes, the page 10. And believe me, that's a grain of salt of easy journaling one can do. That's a grain, if that. Right? That's only 10 things. There's so many more. But tonight, I'm going to show two. So this final video is going to have two easy Bible journaling, creative Bible journaling techniques, right? Quick and simple. So the first one I want to show you is, I'm going to show you two that I did. I did these off camera. One second. One minute here, okay? Just give me a minute. Okay. Okay. All right, sorry about that. So what I want to show you here is like what I did was I put down a sticker and I wrote around it based on a verse, a prayer, or a note to self. I started off here with a prayer, this, and then I continued to write some notes, and it's based on, as for me, this is Psalm 55, verse 19. As for me, I call to God. And the Lord saves me. Evening and morning and noon, I cry out in my distress. And he hears my voice. He rescues me unharmed from the battle that waged against me, even though many oppose me. Okay. God is enthroned from an old who does not change. He will hear them and humble them because they have no fear of God. But I actually journaled on verses 16 through 18. When I tell you this print is small, that print is so small. Ooh, Lord. One second. Let me get my, that other pen is in the room. It's okay. I don't want to lose this page because I want to show you how I did it on this page as well. But it's okay if it's another color. I'm going to put a notation down here to help me remember 16 through 19, even though I highlighted it. Right? And so, and I didn't date it. Sometimes I date it, sometimes I don't. And then I did it on 1 Corinthians 13 as well. And, you know, I did one word. Love, 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 love. I just kept writing the word love, okay? And it's the love chapter, 1 Corinthians 13, but I'm going to highlight 13. But you know what? I think I want to highlight. Why not highlight the entire chapter? Love is indispensable. And my love walk is being tested big time. So, the day I did this page, it was befitting. Okay, this. I don't feel like going all into it, to be honest with you. Because I know at this point I'm going to sound like I'm rambling if I do. And sometimes when I'm doing a video, this I will say, it's not like sometimes I could not be feeling my best, but it's still in my heart to do the video. And tonight is one of those nights where something is, bother me. And I know God is in control and he's handling it. It's still, sometimes, you know, you go through the emotions and all you can do is just trust him. But it's not that you're not going to feel anything. But what you're going to do? After you pray, and then all you can do is stand. My hands are like really dirty from a lot of paint. I was doing some mixed media art. Okay, and so, so now right here, I put a sticker here already, and this is from this booklet. Let me see if I have the booklet here. Oh, I think I'll put it back. It's a happy planner. Let me see. I think I can grab it real quick. Yeah, I think it's from, yeah, it's from this one. The Happy Planner Flowers. Okay. And so, right here, as you can see, I put down the sticker already, so I have to show that. But I think I'm gonna use this pretty pen. Sometimes, you know, you just gotta use a pretty pen. I don't know about you, sometimes using a pretty pen helps me feel better. That was silly, but oh, did I take the I think I took the barrel. Let me see. I think I took the barrel. I gotta refill this. Rats. I had a lot of nice pens here, but let's see. I think I want to use something that's going to contrast with. I think I'm going to use this green pen. So right here, this is Psalm 22. Yeah, Psalm 22. And I'm going to show, instead of showing the one with Psalm 55. Let me go back there. Instead of showing this one, doing it like this, with starting off with a prayer and writing some notes, and the one like 1 Corinthians 13, I'm going to do the one like I did for 1 Corinthians 13, I should say. Writing the one word. And so, looking at chapter 22, verse 11, it says, "Do not be far from me, for trouble is near, and there's no one to help." Right? Okay. So, a psalm of David for the director of music to the tune of the Dole of the Morning. So, you know, this, they say that this verse is prophetic. My God, why have you forsaken me? Starting off with verse 1. You know, because we know Jesus said that when he was hanging on the cross. But this is a psalm of David. And we know David was going through a lot as well, right? Because he was going through with Saul, and then, you know, the people he was leading trying to stone him. He went through a lot. So if you read the Psalms, you're familiar with his struggle, right? So it wouldn't be unheard of to hear him saying to God, "Do not be far from me, for trouble is near, and there is no one to help." And what comes to mind when I read this is, "The Lord is my help. The Lord is my help. The Lord is my help." Isaiah 41:10, right? That's, the Lord's just been ministering that to me. Because sometimes, like, don't get me wrong, I do have help. I do have support, you know, from family, from certain family members, and... But sometimes you can still feel like, depending upon the context where you are, you can still feel a little bit like you like need, not that you don't have help, but sometimes you could just feel like maybe it's that you need more. And again, it depends on context. So I'm just going to give an example. Maybe you're at work and there's something going on at work and you just feel alone there. And, you know, or maybe you're going through something with work and no one really fully understands. So you may feel like a little bit like, but you know God is there. Don't get me wrong. You know God is there, but we're human. And sometimes we just feel like there's no one to help here, God. Like, we could tell that to God, right? And then God reminds us that he's our help. And I need to be reminded constantly, because I know I can't put my expectation on anyone 100%. Like, there's certain relationships with I'm in, of course, marriage, you know, friendship, children, that we do expect some kind of reciprocity to some degree. But sometimes, if we're not careful, it can cross a line where, how can I say, we don't make, it's not make room. Like I said, I might sound like I'm a little rambling tonight because I'm not feeling my best. So I know it's on my heart to do this video. So I'm doing the best with how the Lord is helping me. And sometimes that's being vulnerable and let people see, you know, we're not perfect. I'm not perfect. I don't always bring forth my message with clarity. Sometimes I struggle, but I'm still obedient to go forth. And just let people know, like, you know, I'm sharing the best I can from my heart. And sometimes it's never about trying to appear like the perfect preacher. It's about sharing what God tells us to share from our heart, and not acting like we're some kind of God or we're some kind of Jesus when we're growing to be more like him. So it's probably good for me to come on here and be this vulnerable, even struggling with sharing what's on my heart tonight. But yeah, so oh my God, I lost my train of thought. But yeah, the whole help thing, like God reminded me, he's my help. I forgot what I was saying. I went off, said something else, but that's okay. All right. So yeah, so I'm reminded here. Oh, that's what I was saying. I was saying how, thank you, Lord, how sometimes if we're not careful, we put these unrealistic expectations on people. Sometimes people can't. You know, that doesn't mean that they don't love us. That doesn't mean they don't care. But for whatever reason, they may not be able to show up the way we want them to show up for us, especially if it's something emotional. And sometimes it's God not allowing them because he wants us to turn to him and look to him, right? And so, because we can't put those burdens on people like that. It's like, it's wrong. It's just wrong. And again, it's not saying that we shouldn't expect some kind of reciprocity. But with that, I think true friendship is when someone says they can't, and you can respect that. That I look for that. I look for how a friend handles no. I look for stuff like that, especially when it's something like because they just can't for whatever reason. Maybe something is going on in their life or whatever, and I'm not aware of what's going on or whatever the situation is. But So, you know, when it's times like that, we can feel like a little bit alone and like we don't have any help. The water's running, of course. Hold on one second. It's okay, honey. I'm gonna stop it right now anyway. Okay, so I had to stop the video. But what I did was write, Jesus helps me. Jesus helps me. I kept running into a problem because this sticker has a very clear background, and I couldn't tell what was the sticker part. So you can see that it's like light in between, but you know what, y'all, I was like, oh, I'm still showing this. You know how sometimes I don't know if you do videos, but sometimes it's tempting just to show the stuff that you think came out or beautiful or whatever. But sometimes I don't always want to show all my mistakes, but sometimes I just need to. Jesus is my help. Okay. Good. So, and I highlighted it, as you can see. And so the other one that I wanted to do, right, which is the final one. Oh, God, y'all, I'm looking at my hands, and it look, it's a hot mess with this paint. So I don't even know actually what verse. I'm going to do this one. You know what? I think I do. I think I do. The verse for us. It's this verse. Psalm 40. Yep, this one. Right here. I'm going to do this one right here. Psalm chapter 40, verse 1. I waited patiently for the Lord. He turned to me and heard my cry. So, I am going to journal on that. And what I'm going to do is... one second. I'm going to... where is that? I'm going to use a stamp. Yeah. That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to use a stamp real quick and a transfer rub on, right? And so, I have this heart stamp. And how I want to use it, let me get this right here. Yeah, because my patience is being tested. So, I need this verse. I waited patiently for the Lord. He turned to me and heard my cry. Yeah, I'm being tested to wait patiently for the Lord, y'all. And I know he hears my cry, but I just don't want to have a tantrum because I'm not getting, like, what I'm asking for. I feel like this is a real pressing need. And I'm not doing as well as I would like to do as far as my attitude. But this is something, a new need that I'm experiencing. And so I'm learning how to wait for this kind of need, and it's not easy for me. But I ain't got no choice, but I know, like, if I have a tantrum, that don't mean God gonna answer me. Not saying answer, but give me what I want right away. So, but I'm sure asking and supplicating and telling him how I feel, I'm really trying, like I said, trying not to have a tantrum, because then that's a problem. I don't know if you know what I'm talking about, having a tantrum. Because as adults, we can have tantrums. Okay, let me go ahead and stamp. I did not mean to stamp on those words, y'all. You see? This is what I'm saying. I'm not... oh, my goodness. I stamped on the words. Okay, I'm coming. Oh, okay.
Come say
goodnight
to Auntie. Give her a hug and kiss.
I love you.
I love you too.
Jesus loves you. Sweet dreams. Nighty night.
Bye.
Bye. Talk to Jesus. Baby Bear. Who else? Jeremiah. All right.
And then, my pillow.
Actually, her pillow.
And my covers.
Okay. All right. Thank you, Annie. All right. Okay, y'all. So, like I was saying, you see what I did? Now, I know I don't like to stamp on my words. Oh, my goodness. You know what? And I'm going to show it. I'm sorry. I'm just going to show it, y'all. Oh, Jesus. And this is the final video. But you know what? Maybe this is for the best, because you know something? Look, listen. The bottom line is, we're not always... we have the joy of Jesus in our heart. We have the joy of the Lord. We have the fruit of the Spirit. But sometimes in life, things happen and we don't feel too good about it, folk. And if we don't understand that, when something goes down, we're going to beat ourselves up. Like right now, I'm sharing how I feel about something, but I'm not beating myself up over it. Like, there is a temptation to do that, but, and I'm not making light of, you know, negative attitude. Look, you see? Oh my God, yeah. I cut out the wrong thing. All right. I do not like covering my words, but I wasn't paying attention just now. And I think because I was doing some stamping on some, what is that? That deli paper, that maybe I was still in that frame of mind. So it was, oh my goodness, what is this? Alrighty, y'all. Okay, let's see if I can get this up. How is this doing? This one looks like it's doing right. Lord, help me please with this tonight. This is from the Dollar Tree, this transfer tape, and I don't know, it's a little bit different. Let me see. I hope that I could get it up. I don't know why it's doing that, but it's like it's sticking to the I'm gonna have to end up. Okay. Yeah, I don't like the way this is doing, y'all. Oh my God, that's a hot mess. What is that about? Let me see if I could. Trying to see how the G looks, so I could just at least try to, you know. I'm still gonna go ahead and show this because I think I will be cheating the viewer that watched this last video if I try to like not show this, because the bottom line is, even with quick and simple, maybe this isn't quick and simple, but I'm thinking that it is, because you know I'm using the rubber one. So this, the rubber one, and then the stamp, you know, it's just 1, 2, 3. But it didn't, that didn't happen like that. What I'm gonna do is try to, I have another kind of, where is it now? Let's see. This is gonna bleed through on the other side. So when it's time for me to journal on the other side, I'm definitely gonna have to use, a bookmark type thing, like something like in a column. I'm coming. Because, as you can see, this is gonna bleed through no matter what I do. Yeah, that's already bleeding through. And I don't know. You know what? I'm still gonna go ahead with the other ones, and it may stick, it may not. I wonder if that happened too because of the stamp paper. But I'm sorry, y'all. This right here is not quick and simple. So this is what can happen. You may try to be quick and simple about it, but it may not happen like that. So I think that's okay to say here and just show an authentic issue. So when something like this happens and you don't have a lot of time to journal, you could just put it to the side and then come back to it later. But I'm not going to do that tonight. I'm just going to go ahead and finish it because it's another series in my heart to start, and I think I'm going to do the video for it tonight. That one came out good. You see? I don't know. Look at this mess. Oh my god. Already, that got kind of messed up. But these work a little bit different. But I just believe it's just how I was handling it. I'm not gonna blame that on the rub on. It probably reacted with, like I said, with that ink. That's probably what happened. And so I'm gonna go ahead and put this here. I'll just pray that as I'm doing this, God will comfort me, give me the strength to do what I gotta do. What's this right here? And that is trust him with the process. So I'm gonna leave that, and I think I'm still gonna try to go over this a little bit. Yep. And I'm gonna still try to go over it some more, even with that black mark, that black marker. Well, not marker. The Faber-Castell pen. Oh my goodness. All right. So, I'm going to go ahead and cut out the rest of this. I need that, I got an R. The other R got messed up. I think I could still use that R. Let's see. But I know now, make sure that the letters don't, go on any paper or on top of each other, because it's going to stick, as we can see. I need this H. Oopsie. Oops. The good thing is, like, it stick to this paper here. Oh, I don't even know if you could see where I was just pointing, because so God hears. I'm gonna go all the way right here. God hears me. So, because he heard my cry. So, I'm going to have to, and this is why I don't like covering up my words, because I have to read, like, this is not my Bible that I read, but if I do want to read it, I want my words. I want to be able to read my words, but, you know, it was a mistake, and I'm going to just go ahead, and I'm going to write out the verse. That's what I'm going to do. It's Psalm 41. I waited patiently for the Lord. He turned to me and heard my cry. This is going to go over anyway. It's going to go over the way that I did it. So, if you're somebody is watching this and you don't like the words covered up, do not come for me. I don't think nobody should be going for nobody that does that. I just think it's haughty. Because the bottom line is that, you know, I have a certain respect and appreciation for YouTubers. When I'm watching their content. Because the bottom line, nobody owes me nothing. Okay? They could take their giftings and go and sell it on Udemy. I mean, I think about the stuff that I learn on YouTube. From YouTube. And I know some of these people, they can go and get paid for what they're doing. Like really. They really can go. I think I'm going to have to wait to do the R and the S, because I really see a big problem happening if I try to put that. They could go and they can go on Udemy, Skillshare, like some of the stuff that, you know, I know full well you can pay, they can get paid for that in an art class or something like that. A lot of people that I watch on YouTube, and even those that may not have the highest skill level when it comes to art and or learning, just such as myself, believe me, that somewhere someone will appreciate it enough to pay for something. Even if it's that we're given our time. And so now when I see people going to Patreon, I say, okay, you know, because some people jump on people's channel and they say whatever because they feel like they are a subscriber, and I guess they feel like the people's channel is at their mercy. And so some people say whatever, or I'm gonna unsubscribe, and it's like, I say to myself, like, where is the appreciation that you're getting free content? Like, you don't have to pay for a class. Or, I just say, I got to be humble about it, because everybody doesn't think the same. But God, just help me not to do that, because I understand, like, they owe me nothing. They really do not owe me anything. You know, that person, they could go and take their skill somewhere else where some and get paid for it. I'm not paying them for it. You know, look at that. That's a mess. This is nowhere near Eat Quick and Simple, y'all. Not this one. But I still just wanted to continue on. So. What time is it? This is a hot rockin' sockin' mess. And I really believe it has something to do with this kind of paper, this, that stamp on there. But what I'm going to do, I'm going to use it as a guide to do the other letters. I just hope it don't rip on me. Let me see if I could. I just hope it ain't ripping the paper from the other side. You know what I mean? Like putting a hole in it. Yeah, so when I, like I was saying, when I see them go on the Patreon, whatever this, oh, it did rip the page. The page just ripped. Let me see. Oh, no. It ripped it up, but it's not ripped like that. So. And don't get me, I appreciate those that subscribe to my channel and those that watch my videos. You know, I've never had anyone, well, I think I had a couple, I had people that try to troll me, like, with them nasty, like, they try to put, like, a time stamp in the, description section of the video, of the comment section. I don't click on those, but it's like of a sexual nature. And so what I'll do is there's a way to like spam it. I'll spam it, but then I also learned how to put it. It's in this filter thing and you put it there. And what ends up happening is that the algorithm picks it up and they don't, you know, let their video, they don't let their comment go through. But but what happens is some of these people that do that, they have multiple accounts. So I've had issues with another one popping up, but it just stopped. But every now and again I'll see one. And then I had a couple of people sometimes came on and made a haughty statement. And I responded to one of them, but I wasn't like disrespectful. I've had a person come on my Instagram a couple of times with sarcasm, and I didn't rebuke them by saying their name. But I just restricted their comment and then I posted a rebuke. See, I was like, Lord, please help me. Because, see, I don't want to say, I will give a rebuke. I just didn't want to say anything disrespectful, you know. And then it's sometimes like I could discern, I can't explain it. But it's, well, you know, sometimes, you know, when it's something you really, with discernment, you can't really explain it, right? Because it's a knowing, like a word of wisdom, whatever. It's not always because the person, it's not always because you can explain it like that. But I could tell, like, this individual is some, like, fake boldness that they have because they're on the other side of the screen. Oh, you know what? I wonder if that happened because it wasn't hard enough under there. Let me see something. Because I don't know. I just pick up, like, they would not have said a couple of the things that they said on my posts had we been in person. And I know that sounds really immature when you talk about you going to be in the street fighting. No. I mean, back in the day, yeah. Like, back in the day, I would be like, because I don't bother people. But if you step to me, I was going to act crazy enough to make sure you don't step to me again. Because some people, they don't hear you when you talk. That's how I used to think when I... Now I know better. I can't go around acting like that. Besides, I'm older. I might get beat up. But back in the day, I wasn't thinking like that. I was going to show you, like, rock your knot real quick and let you know, don't mess with me. And it was like, I would go all out crazy because I just wanted to make sure that the person was not going to come back and harass me. I didn't have time for bullies. And so it's like, in my mind, I'm thinking this person is a bully and they're not going to stop. Look at that, y'all. Look at that. I think, uh-oh. See? It was moi. See, it was how I had that. That is something. That is something. That is something. Oh, well. Ain't nothing I could do about that now. But try to go and make an E and an H. Oh, good Lord. All right. I'll just go ahead. Because I was going to go over it anyway. Because the G is like, you know. So, I already had in my mind to go over it anyway. So that's how I was thinking back then. You know. It was like a strategy to act real crazy so you could ward off the bullies. Well, you know, but when we get older and we trust in the Lord don't want us in the street fighting and acting crazy. And like I said, besides, I'm older now. I'm getting beat up. who you fighting in the street? I'm not an old woman, but I'm older. You better go sit down somewhere and pray. Let the Lord fight that battle. You're going to come out with your knot rocked. Because you can't fight no more. Not like that. So anyways. Let's see. I could try to. I don't even know how to do this thing like this. What am I doing? This is a mess. I'll do the best I can. This is so not quick and simple. Oh my goodness. That's funny. That is funny. What you gonna do? What I'm gonna do? I could not just post this part. And I could just do a simple voiceover. But nah. I'm gonna show it. Somebody will probably enjoy it. I don't know. I think I'm having fun right now just being transparent. Sometimes I like it. Sometimes I don't. It depends on what it is, though, to be honest with you. And it has a lot to do with how I feel. But I know it's God helping me because, oh my goodness, y'all. I was feeling stanky dank dank. And I feel a little better. But I was not. Okay, so I don't know how many of y'all watching this that are preachers, but you ever felt you had to preach something and you wasn't living up to it? And the Lord said, you're going to preach it anyway because I'm talking to you and I'm going to be talking to somebody else, but I'm also talking to you. So let me tell you, and please, I'm not saying my husband and I are fighting. No, by the grace of God, we not. I pray that God keep us by the grace of God. So I just want to put that out there because, you know, and, you know, by the grace of God, We talk things out. And God is faithful because, you know, I had enough dysfunction. So Lord knows I ain't need to get married to have more. Please no, Lord. My heart couldn't bear it. But I'm just want to give this example. Then I go back to, like, you know, sharing, not specifically my situation, but, you know, speaking in generics, but still transparent. So she said, I think it was Sandra Utterbach from years ago. It was her or someone else. And she said that she had to do a series on marriage. And she was upset, and they were pastors. And she said that her and her husband were arguing. And every day she would be like, before they went to the church, she would be like, God, why you have me preach? Why you have us preaching on marriage? And we're struggling. And God said, because the more you preach it, the more you hear it. And you're going to learn and you're going to change. So she was not left. The thing about it was they weren't off the hook because they were struggling. So that scenario just came back to me when I thought about, like, how, you know, sometimes have you ever been in a situation where you feel like you're struggling with something and you gotta preach on it and you're like, but God, you know, you can almost feel like a hypocrite because it's like, I'm struggling here, God. And he is like, that is not gonna let you off the hook for saying what I'm telling you to say. You know, and you know, and I think, like, my thing tonight is, like, okay, my attitude prior, well, it's getting better now as I'm doing this and just, you know, talking or whatever. I didn't feel like the best coming on here and sharing scripture and Bible journaling with, you know, not feeling my best and feeling like my attitude is not that good today. And plus, you know, grace, right? Because I wasn't feeling too well today. I actually stayed home. And I stayed home because I wasn't feeling that well. And so, you know, sometimes when we're not feeling too well, we're even more vulnerable to not having the best attitude. And, you know, I felt like my attitude wasn't indicative of knowing that God hears me, of knowing that God is helping me, you know. And I feel kind of bad about it. I do feel bad about it, but I ask God to forgive me. And so I'm not going to beat myself up about it. But when that does happen, I do feel bad because I'm like, he's perfect. He's not doing anything wrong. You know, it's me. It's my humanity. So I extend grace to myself. But I also know I have to say sorry to God, too, because I could be kind of fussy. And like I said, I don't want to have a tantrum. And I was on the verge of one. You know, I don't mind pouring out, making my complaint to the Lord. I believe that's Psalm 27:17. But when it starts to turn to murmuring, I have to be careful. I don't want to start grumbling, you know, but it does happen. You just have to repent, you know, and say, Lord, help, because he knows. So this is not quick. I'm going to have to name this quick and simple with a little bit of, I don't know what I'm going to name it, with my mess ups. Quick and simple, final video, quick and simple. turned long and messy. Yeah, maybe something like that. With chit chat. With a chit chat. I'm gonna start this other series. I'm gonna do that other video tonight, I think. But you know what? Thank God, y'all. Because you know what I'm learning right now? The Holy Spirit said to me, you see, you're not being led by your emotions. Thank you, Father. Because I could have just went in the room, went in the bed, and pouted. But He graced me to do this video. And right now, I just wanna cry. I'm just grateful because I guess, I don't know, maybe that's what He wanted to do. Like, because it's so easy to say, you know what, I ain't doing no video. I ain't doing nothing out, you know. All right, y'all, so I'm going a step further because this is already turned long and a bit messy, but I got mistakes here, but I feel like crying. Well, I am a little bit. Y'all don't see that, but I'm liking the page with all of the mess ups. So oh boy, thank you, Lord. I did not expect this to happen, but all right, y'all, I'm done here. I know I'm really quiet. I ain't put no music either. Sometimes it's like that when I'm journaling. It's real quiet. I can't even put no music and just sit and just journal. Or just art. And be praying. Yeah, y'all, so, I can't even highlight that because I can't see what's in there. Alrighty, so that's it. That's it, beautiful people. That is it. This prayer here says, Dear Father God, Dear Father God, I trust you to help me wait patiently. Thanks for hearing my prayer. Oh, in Jesus' name. Amen. Help me, Lord. All right, so that's it for this series. Oh my goodness, I feel funny like this is supposed to be quick and simple. You're not ending like that, dear. But if you watch the video from beginning to end, you know what happened. And there's a lot of life lessons there. Some things are not meant to be quick and simple. Sometimes it is, sometimes it isn't. And I guess tonight was one of those nights where the Lord wanted to show that even sometimes if you want it quick and simple, there's nothing wrong with quick and simple. Sometimes we need it quick and simple, but sometimes it's not going to be quick and simple. And sometimes it is when we think it's going to be more challenging. What you going to do? What we going to do? So that's it for this video. Oopsie. Oh my goodness. I got it. Oops, wait a second here. Okay, yeah, so that's it. So, if you're going through anything tonight, whatever it may be, I pray that God comforts you and gives you what you stand in need of, and that you're encouraged. Tonight, I pray that if you have to wait on the Lord for something and you're finding it challenging waiting on him, I pray that God will help you to wait on him. However, I know he will not leave us comfortless. Because he knows when it's a struggle, he knows when it's a challenge. He's not dismissive of our emotions, although it's not like he stops working with us because of our emotions, or that we should be led by our emotions. We're led by the Spirit. However, God wants to heal us in those places where we're wounded, and he, again, doesn't dismiss our emotions. He heals us in those places. And he helps us as we navigate our emotions to obey him and still follow him regardless of how we are feeling. And I thank him for his grace and how he will, I know he will help me. I know he will help you. God helps us as his children. He promised us, right, that he will never leave us nor forsake us. And when we are in that hour of need, whatever it is, we may not get it. We get what we need. What we probably need is not the, what we, sometimes what we need is not the first and foremost thing that we think we need. It could be something else that we don't see. And God is like, I'm giving you what you need in that moment, but you don't think I'm giving you what you need because you're not seeing it from my perspective. And, you know, and then sometimes it's like, okay, we're going through that where we're suffering lack. Like Paul said, I learned to be content in every situation. And sometimes that's the need to learn how to be content and wait. Yikes, it don't feel too good. But God is in control. So I pray for all of you tonight, even if you're not going through anything. I pray God bless your lives. And whatever you stand in need of, that he will provide for you. And be encouraged wherever you are. Okay, so with that being said, thanks for watching. God bless you. And please remember that Jesus loves you no matter what. Bye-bye.